The angle of repose, or critical angle of repose, of granular material is the steepest angle of descent relative to a horizontal plane, in which the powder is poured to create an angle from 0 degrees to 90 degrees. This will show us the properties of our powder. A cohesive powder will form an irregular heap, where a non-cohesive powder will form a regular, conical heap. For testing the angle of repose, we will follow the US Pharmacopoeia method described in General Chapter 1174. There is not a defined method or equipment for testing the angle of repose in the USP. Because of this, LFA has developed a method in which we feel fits the requirements outlined in the USP of being practical, useful, reproducible, sensitive, and yield meaningful results. To test the angle of repose, we are using the LFA ART1 angle of repose tester. To perform this test, take your powder and gently pour it into the funnel. Stir the sample if necessary. Once the powder has formed a pile on the platform, measure the height of the powder from the platform to the highest point on its peak in millimeters. The tangent of the angle of repose in degrees can be determined by reading off the height of the powder cone in millimeters from the digital display. Here's the calculation to calculate the angle of repose. However, LFA does have a calculator on our website to do the math for you, which we'll link below. Tan 1. H is the pile of the powder and D is the diameter. Using a scientific calculator, multiply the height by 2 and divide this value by the diameter. Then hit the inverse tan key, or tan 1, and the answer just calculated. This will give you the angle of repose. Here is a table of how the angle of repose might affect the ability of the powder to flow. An angle between 25 to 30 degrees will show excellent flow, meaning the formulation will move through your hopper, feed frame, dye table, and dye bore smoothly. However, from 41 to greater than 66 degrees, you may experience issues such as rat holing or bridging within your hopper. Bridging is where an arch is formed over the hopper's funnel, and rat holing is where a small hole or narrow channel forms to the outlet and therefore will lead to poor flow. You may also get the same issues in the dye bore, where the formulation is incorrectly filling in the dye bores, leading to varying tablet weights and sizes. For more information on the LFA ART1, please visit www.lfamachines.com.